Greetings. We're examining Islam's logical problems. Another way to say it is examining Islam's illogical claims. Who is the first Muslim? Muhammad made claim to be the first Muslim in several surahs. Surah 6:14, say, shall I take as a helper or protector any other than Allah, the creator of the heavens and earth? And it is he who feeds but is not fed. Say, verily I am commanded to be the first of those who submit themselves to Allah as Muslims. And be not you of the mushrikan. Surah 6:163, he hath no associate. This am I commanded, and I am the first of the Muslims. Surah 39:12, Aliyun al translation, and I am commanded to be the first and foremost in being Muslim. Being the first means that no one has been before. The first man to summit Everest was Sir Edmund Hillary. The first man to step on the moon was Neil Armstrong. No other footprint could be found there before him. And in three places in the Quran, it is claimed Muhammad is the first Muslim, the first to submit to Allah. Surah 39:12, and I am commanded that I shall be the foremost of those who surrender in Islam, the first ever to practice or follow Islam. But Islam also tries to claim Abraham was a Muslim. Surah 3:67, Ibrahim was not a Jew, nor a Nazarene, or Christian, but he was an upright Muslim, nor was he of the associators, polytheists, idolaters. Maybe this word first does not mean what you think it means. Islam also tries to claim the disciples of Jesus were Muslims. Surah 3:52, when Issa sensed kufr in their part, he said, who will be my helpers to Allah? The disciples said, we are Allah's helpers. We believe in Allah. Bear witness that we are Muslims. Surah 5:111, and recall what time I revealed to the disciples, believe in me and my apostle. They said, we have believed and bear thou witness that verily we are Muslims. That would seem to document another 12 men before Muhammad who were Muslims. This would seem to refute Muhammad's claim to be the first Muslim. Islam tries to claim all the prophets of Israel were Muslim. Islam also tries to claim Jesus himself was a Muslim. However, Islam must make this claim by inference, as all the prophets of Israel were Muslims. Islam specifically names the 25 prophets of Islam, all of them Muslim by virtue of being prophets of Islam, of course. 24 of them coming before Muhammad, the first Muslim. All of them Jewish, except Muhammad, the Jew-hater. But tell a Mohammedan the error of being the first Muslim, and they have a ready answer. They will answer by adding words to the Quran. Muhammad was the first Muslim of his group. And that seems almost logical, to allow for the implied qualifier of his group or of his time. I guess Muhammad did not know his father's name. Abdullah, the slave of Allah. So before Muhammad was obedient and submissive to Allah, Muhammad's father was. So Muhammad cannot even be called the first in his family. And I would honestly expect the first invention contrived to cover this problem to be, Abdullah was a slave of Allah in name only. Abdullah was not a true, real Muslim. If they were willing to throw Muhammad's father under the bus, that would indicate honor the father and mother of your prophet isn't an Islamic rule. But what about a Muslim trying to change the claim to, no, Muhammad was the first prophet to his people. Yes, that is what it means. You have just crossed over into the realm of imagination and invention, a realm of lies and frauds where baseless claims are made up like a child caught lying. You have just entered the Dawa Zone. Da-da-da-da. Islam also claims every nation had a prophet, warner, messenger. One must assume these prophets were also Muslims in good standing with Allah, even though there is not one atom of evidence that any of them ever existed. But not one of these prophets to other nations made the top 25 list of Islamic prophets. Only the 24 prophets of Israel, who all came before Muhammad, the first Muslim. The honest explanation is that Muhammad faced two conflicting needs. He had to claim firstness, to be foremost and superior during his lifetime. But he also needed strategically to steal credentials from the Torah and Bible and true prophets of God. And a simple, straightforward way to attempt that is to claim all the real prophets already followed his new religion. That this logically contradicted his claim to be first did not matter to his followers then, any more than it matters to them now. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.